Google Search Console is a site owner's best friend. You can find keywords a page is ranking for, identify the indexability of a page, find underperforming pages, etc. But do you know there are some useful features not many people are talking about? So in this video, we'll talk about all the things you can do with Google Search Console, starting with those that are lesser known. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one tool that empowers millions of WordPress sites with easy-to-use SEO and AI tools, and this channel is all about sharing the right SEO knowledge. So if you're new to us, consider subscribing. Now, let's start with something a little advanced. So we are on the Google Search Console. To find the keywords your site is ranking for, you can go to Performance, and right at the bottom, under the Queries tab, here are all the keywords your site is ranking for. Now, to find query keywords like those that start with or contain who, what, where, when, why, and how, right over here, click on New to add a new filter, then select Query. Following that, you want to select Custom Regex. Regex is simply the short form of regular expression, which means they will filter your data based on a set of conditions. And then to filter the query keywords, you will start by adding this set of operator, followed by this, without leaving any spaces in between. And as you hit Apply, you will see all the queries that contain what. If you want to find keywords that contain how instead, you'll click on this and change this to how. Hit Apply, and here we are. The same is true when you want to find keywords that contain where, who, when, why, and etc. All you need to do is just to change the text here. And if you want to find multiple query type keywords, for example, how, where, and what, all you need to do is to add this symbol to separate the words. For example, this. And if you want to add another word, separate it like this. Make sure that you leave no spaces in between, otherwise it won't work. As you hit Apply, here are all the keywords that contain either one of the words you have specified. Do you find this useful? Try it on your Google Search Console and see if it works, and let us know in the comments. Anyway, there's more. You can use Regex to filter out keywords based on the number of characters, such as this set of operators will filter out keywords with less than 10 characters. As you hit Apply, you will see all these keywords are below 10 characters. Then for queries with between 10 to 30 characters, you just need to change the numbers here from 1 to 10, which is the minimum character count, and from 10 to 30, which is the maximum character count. And as you hit Apply, you will get a set of keywords with between 10 to 30 characters. And if you want keywords with more than 30 characters, you just have to change the minimum to 30 and remove the maximum. And you will get what you need. Now, you can also filter the keywords by the number of words instead of characters. To filter keywords with just one word, you can use this set of operators and it will show you keywords with just one word. For medium tail keywords like 2 to 3 words, you can use this operator instead. And you will see a list of keywords with 2 to 3 words. And then for long tail keywords, meaning 4 words or more, just change the minimum to 3 and leave the maximum blank. And now you will have keywords with more than 4 words. Okay, I know it is a little tough for you to type out the entire string of operators, so to help you out, we've placed a link in the description to our written article, and in there, you'll find all the operators we have talked about. Now let's go deeper. Let's say that we want to filter our keywords containing what, and we want to limit the number of words to 4. How do we do that? So on the custom regex, we will start with this set of operator to filter out a list of query keywords containing what, and then hit space and add the medium tail word count filter. For this, you have to leave a space in between for it to work. And you have to remove this because there is already one in front. If you keep this here, it will not work. Let me show you. As you can see, there is no data here. So what you need to do is to remove this. Hit apply. And here we go. You will see a list of keywords containing what and has a maximum of 4 words. So feel free to play around with the regex formulas, and if you are an expert in regex and you have something unique, please share it with us in the comments. We really appreciate that. Anyway, let's go to the next use case. Now, Google has always claimed that whenever you publish a new piece of content, updated it, or made changes to it, they will always detect the changes without you manually submitting the pages to them, right? But what if they made a mistake? What if you have updated your content, but Google has not crawled them in months? This means that your content is losing ranking opportunity as your updated content could have made the page rank at the top. But how do you identify those pages that are not crawled? Simple. On your Search Console, under Indexing, click on Pages. You want to click on View Data About Index Pages. And then you want to sort the last crawled column to see those pages that were not crawled recently. If you have updated one of these pages, but they are still not crawled, so let's say that you have updated this page on 13th of March, the last crawled was a day before that, and now it's already May, you know you have to do something about it. Hover to the page, copy the URL, paste the URL in the inspection tool right at the top, and then once the URL inspection is done, click on Request Indexing, and Google will send its spiders to crawl your page again. The other way is to use instant indexing, which could speed up the indexing process for your entire site. If you want to learn more about that, you can check out this video right here. The link is in the description. So Google is technically a machine and they can make mistakes. So don't hesitate to point them in the direction if they miss something. Now, if your site has structured data improvements to be made, they would not be apparent to you in the dashboard because they are not errors that prevents a page from getting rich snippets. However, you should know where to find these issues and fix them so that Google has more context about your pages. On the dashboard of your Google Search Console, you see as you scroll down, you will see the structured data enhancement with only the valid or invalid data. If there are improvements to be made, meaning any improvements marked with yellow instead of green or red, you will not see it in the dashboard. So as you scroll to the enhancement section, you will see all the structured data implemented on your site. We recommend that you visit these individual tabs at least once a month to discover possible schema issues marked with yellow that needs to be addressed so that Google will understand your pages even more. So put it in your calendar to check your Search Console once a month for any potential schema issues. Now, if for some reason you want to remove pages from search results instantly, the quickest way is to use the removal tool from Google Search Console. On your Search Console, under the indexing category, you will see the removals tool. Click on New Request, and you can remove either a single URL or an entire subdirectory by adding its prefix. Take note that this is just a temporary solution. Google and other search engines may still index a URL after a while if nothing else is done. So to permanently remove a page from search, you want to make sure to mark the page as no index. If you are using RankMath, all you have to do is to visit the intended page, and on the RankMath tab, select the Advanced tab, and right here at the Robots Meta, you can check no index. And remember to update to save the changes. This is the permanent way to remove your page from the search results. Now, this is a little technical, but I will try to explain it in layman's terms. When you are the owner of a website and you're trying to verify your site with Google Search Console, you will have a couple of options for verification. And for some methods, you will have to add a line of code. We call it ownership token to specific areas of your site or hosting. Once you have verified your site on your Google Search Console settings, and users and permissions, you'll be listed as the owner of a Search Console account with a verified mark. That's quite basic, right? Here comes the complex part. Let's say that I sold the website to you, and let's say that this is your account and this is mine. One of the steps for you as the new site owner is to remove me as an owner of the Google Search Console. So what you will do is to click on Options and Remove Access. Click on Remove User and done. Check this out. I was able to access the Search Console, and now as I refresh the page, I no longer have access to it. However, that is not the end. Remember, when I was the owner, I have added a line of code to the website or hosting to get verified. And if that line of code is not removed, I now have the power to re-verify myself and gain access to the Search Console again, even if I do not have access to your website anymore. Now, this is serious. What if I am a very bad person and I go to the removals tool and request to remove all the URLs from your site? That's gonna cause a huge impact on you.
Sure, the removals are temporary, but during the period where the search engines remove your URLs, you are losing traffic and money every single day. So Google Search Console has this function. Let me refresh this again. Now you see I'm back as an owner of the Google Search Console. So what you want to do is to remove access of the previous owner. And then over here, you will see one unused ownership token. Click on that and it will tell you the type of verification done. Click on remove and make sure that you remove this line of code from where it was placed. For example, in our case, the line of code is in the theme file editor under header.php. And over here, this is the line of code. We need to remove it, update the file, and back to the search console again to verify the removal. Only when the unused token is removed, then it will not pose any security risk. Now, when the nasty guy tries to refresh the Google Search Console, they will not have access to it. And if they try to verify their ownership, they would have to go through the same process again. But now they do not have access to your site or any of these assets, so you're safe. So this unused ownership tokens function was not available in the past. You will have to guess if the verification tokens are still on your website or not, and this poses a security risk. And it could be a very tough job to go through every line of code on your site to find the token. So with this feature, it will scan your site to see if they still detect the token, and it makes your life as a new site owner easier. Now, to identify underperforming pages, you will need to compare the current performance to the previous year performance. And Google Search Console has that function. So on your Search Console, go to Performance, click on the Date filter, set it to Compare, and select Compare last 28 days to previous period. Then click Apply. Following that, you want to select pages so that you know which pages are underperforming as compared to last year's performance. Then sort the data by click difference and impressions difference. Focus on those pages with negative differences and you will find those underperforming pages. Once you have gathered those underperforming pages, it's time to work on them. Now, when many external sites are linking to a particular page of your site, in other words, backlinks, it gives search engines a good signal that the page is useful. And in SEO slang, those links provide link juice. And when that page has internal links to many other pages of your site, it spreads the link juice and will eventually help the entire site rank better. The question is, how do you know which page on your site has the most backlinks or link juice to distribute? On the menu of your Search Console, scroll to the bottom and you will find the Links tab. Over here, you will see the top pages with the most external links. In other words, these are the pages that have the most link juice. Then look to the right, these are the pages with the most internal links. So if you add internal links from the pages with the most link juice to those pages with the most internal links, the link juice will spread far and wide, which is good for SEO. However, do note that when you add internal links, make sure that they are relevant. For example, the best organic and natural body washes is relevant to the page on ingredients to avoid impersonal care products. So you want to link them up. But this page is not relevant to be energy efficient at home. So don't try to force an internal link between these two pages. Relevance is key to effective internal link building. Just keep that in mind. Now to the last use case. The Google Search Console is the best place to find keyword gems because it is practically telling you what keywords your pages can potentially rank for. On the Performance tab of your Search Console, you want to click on this to turn on the average click-through rate column. Click-through rate basically means the percentage of people who click and visit your page when they see it on the search results. So what you want to do is to click on Pages. We recommend visiting every page possible to find keyword opportunities. But let's take for example the page on Get Paid to Review Phone Calls. Click on it, and then you want to select Queries. This will tell you all the queries or keywords this page is ranking for. What you want to do is to sort the data by the click-through rate and focus on those queries that have poor click-through rate. Most of the time, you will find keyword ideas to create a new piece of content. For example, now I know there is a program called CallRevu and I can write a review on them. People are searching for jobs like Humanetic. I can write an article on that. There's another program called Coin by Call, which I can explore. How much does Humanetic pay per call? You see, with a simple step, you will find many keyword ideas. Now, you can also use the data here to optimize for keywords your page has the potential to rank for. So what you can do is to click on the average position to add the position column to the data. Look for keywords that are in the average position of between 7 to 15. These are the keywords you need to optimize your page for. The page is not ranking so well for these keywords because maybe some information is outdated or it is missing something. You want to investigate the reasons why they are not ranking so well for these keywords so that as you improve for these keywords, your page will perform better. So, what do you think of these awesome things you can do with the Google Search Console? Do you find them helpful? Do let us know in the comments. And of course, if you have any other Search Console use cases that I have not shared, feel free to leave them in the comments as well. Anyway, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, we are all about sharing the right SEO and AI knowledge. So do consider subscribing. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.